Okay, in today's session, so I'm going to start from this slide, huh? From this slide, which is about the magnetic behavior of a ferromagnetic material. So when we talk about a ferromagnetic material, actually, we are generally describing about material, lah. Huh? If you have a look at this notes, huh? Material, we can divide the material into the material that can be used in electricity. For example, we can categorize the material that is suitable for conducting the electricity. We call it as conductor, right? Like copper. Copper is a good conductor in electricity, in conducting electricity ataupun conducting the current. And then, selain daripada material yang which can conduct electricity, there is also material that is non-conducting. Maknanya kita tak boleh menjadikan dia sebagai material untuk conducting the electricity, ataupun kita panggil insulator lah. Okay, ada dua jenis, sama ada insulator ataupun konduktor. Ada satu lagi sebenarnya, semiconductor. Semiconductor ni satu lagi bidang yang besar lah. Eh? Selain daripada konduktor ataupun insulator, kan. So, begitu juga dalam bidang magnetik. Okay? Dalam bidang magnetik, ada material yang non-magnetik. Ada material yang ferromagnetik. So, the material which is non-magnetic like glass, kaca kan, kayu ke ataupun plastik. Okay. So, contohnya plastik. Plastik pun ni sebenarnya kalau kita, dia bukan magnetic material. Maksudnya kalau kita windingkan dia dan kita lalukan current, dia tak akan jadi magnet lah. Okay. Unlike the ferromagnetic material, which is the other category, ferromagnetic material like iron or nickel or cobalt ni, bila kita lalukan current macam tadilah, eh, macam itu tunjuk tadi, dia akan menjadikan iron tersebut sebagai magnet. Okay? What we expect from a non-magnetic material, for example, as you can see, bila kita supply current, okay, bila kita supply current, kita expect that if we plot the B versus I ni, B yang dihasilkan ataupun magnetic field intensity yang dihasilkan itu, magnetic flux density kan, yang dihasilkan itu kita expect linear. Linear maksudnya, current bertambah 2 amps, B bertambah sebanyak gandaan sama, 2 amps juga. 2 Weber per meter square contohnya kan. Maknanya linear relationship. 1 to 1. Okay? Okay, next. Okay, then ferromagnetic material ini sebenarnya it is characterized by permeability. Okay? Permeability determines the magnetic characteristics of the ferromagnetic material. Okay? For example, the permeability of the iron is much more larger than the permeability of the free space. Okay? So, and then the permeability of the ferromagnetic material is not constant. Okay? Unlike the permeability of the free space, it is constant. You, mu note ini, free space punya permeability constant. So, maksudnya, maksudnya, mu naught ini dalam free space ataupun vacuum, constant. Tetapi, apa yang membezakan ferromagnetic material ni, dia punya mu adalah tidak constant. Maksudnya, bila kita supply current, okay, benda tu akan menjadi magnet. Semakin kuat current, semakin tinggi sifat magnet bagi benda itu. Tetapi, pada satu-satu masa, walaupun kita tambah lagi current, benda tu dah tak jadi macam, dia dah macam dah tepu dah. Dia jadi magnet. Tapi dia tak dari segi magnetic characteristics dia tu tak ada bertambah lagi. Maksudnya dia dah tepu lah. Okay. So, itu yang dimaksudkan dengan permeability. Ya. So, permeability play the main role in the ferromagnetic material, which is, it is the property that determine the magnetic characteristics lah. Alright. So, in electrical machines, normally kita expect that bila kita tambah current, kita akan increase the B ataupun magnetic MMF tu kan. Kita tambah MMF, tambah current, B tu akan bertambah. Maknanya makin kuatlah B kan. Tetapi kita tak boleh expect that the B ataupun flux ini akan bertambah secara linear. Sebab sampai satu tahap dia akan jadi tepu dan walaupun kita increase the current, flux will no longer increase. But very, very small increase. Still increasing but very small increase. Okay. So that is what we call as the magnetizing curve. Okay. Ini yang inilah yang kita namakan sebagai magnetizing curve. As you can see, okay, this is the magnetizing curve. Saya dah lukiskan sini. Bila kita tambahkan MMF, okay, x-axis ini, flux akan bertambah. Dan penambahan flux ini sebenarnya dia bukan pada pada macam ni. One to one bukan. Maksudnya nisbah dia, flux ini bertambah sangat banyak walaupun kita increase very small increase in current, it will increase almost double the flux. Okay. Maknanya in ferromagnetic material macam itulah specialnya. Kita increase sedikit current pun sifat kemagnetisan apa dalam bahasa Melayu kan. The magnetizing characteristic itu bertambah sangat banyak. Sehinggalah sampai satu tahap lah. Okay. Ini dipanggil bahagian unsaturated region. Region yang tidak tepu. Dan apabila dia sampai satu yang kita panggil knee point ini, dia akan mula saturated dan this region is called as the saturation region. So when you have a look at this phi versus F and B versus H ini, make sure that you can imagine this. Which is, this is how do we imagine this curve, alright? We do the looping or winding to this ferromagnetic material or iron core, for example, and we supply the current, and it has n number of turns. Okay, so meaning that we are giving it F, which is MMF, which is n times I, right? So if we increase the current, flux that is flowing inside this ferromagnetic core will be increasing. Then we plot this, right? Okay, and then we do the relationship lah. H ini directly proportional to the MMF and also phi is directly proportional to B. Alright? Okay, why do we choose the ferromagnetic material? Because it increase the flux exponentially. So sangat banyak flux dapat dihasilkan walaupun dengan sedikit current. Itu dia punya specialty lah. That is why kita menggunakan ferromagnetic material yang sangat bagus, contohnya iron. Most of the devices like transformer, DC machine, AC machine, generator, semua dia punya material tu, dia punya plate dalam tu kan. Transformer ada plate tu kan. So plate tu diperbuat daripada iron. Okay. Lamination. Iron lamination. And then since ferromagnetic material ini, dia punya sifat dia, dia akan saturated. Okay. Dia punya sifat dia, dia akan saturated after some time, after it's beyond the knee point here. In electric machine, okay, in electric machine, in machine lah. Basically, how do we operate the machine? We will make sure that we operate the machine near the knee point, which is around here. Operation of the machine setakat ni lah, maknanya at certain amount of current, bila kita tambah lagi current, dia dah tak berfungsi dengan cekap lah. Maksudnya dia walaupun tambah current, merugikan lah, dia akan ada loss kan. Okay, so kita akan operate kita punya machine at near the knee point to make sure the operation of the machine is optimal. Okay. Then, energy losses in ferromagnetic core, which is the following slides. Energy losses in ferromagnetic core. Okay, this is another topic which is interesting to describe. And the beginning chapter, kita bincang jugalah berkenaan dengan energy losses, like hysteresis losses and then the eddy current losses. When we arrive in another chapter, in chapter 2, chapter 3 and chapter 4, also we'll be discussing in more details about these losses that is associated with the AC and DC machine, transformer and so on. Okay, so basically this is the fundamental. What is actually the hysteresis loss? Kita pernah dengar hysteresis loss. So far, if you have a look at this, saya tunjukkan yang saya lukis lah, lambat untuk slides. Oh, sorry, salah. Ini WhatsApp. Okay, if you have a look at this core, kita supply current macam ni kan. So basically, I've been talking about DC current. Maknanya, kita bagi current, supply current dalam satu hala saja, in one direction. Maksudnya current masuk kat sini, dia pusing dalam ni, dia keluar kat bawah ni. Itu DC current lah, one direction. Bila DC current, bila kita plot phi versus F ini, dia akan linear dan naik macam tu kan. So how about AC current? Macam mana pula dengan AC current? So AC current, basically, you can imagine that when we supply the AC current, suppose it should be like this, sinusoidal waveform, right? So AC current, dia akan ada positive cycle and negative cycle. Maksudnya, kita supply current daripada atas turun bawah kan? And then, dia akan, itu positive cycle. Untuk negative cycle, dia akan go back then return. Okay, in 50 Hz cycle, for example, about 0.02 second. 0.02 second, it change its direction. Itu maksud 50 Hz. Alright, so boleh imagine tak, dalam masa 0.02 second, it change from positive cycle to negative cycle. Okay, that 50 Hz frequency of AC current, what will happen? Apa yang akan berlaku pada flux ni? Apa yang berlaku pada flux? Kita expect that flux ni akan, bila positive cycle, dia akan menaik macam ni. Bila negative cycle, dia akan turun balik. Okay? Nanti saya akan tunjuk contoh lebih detail. Kita expect macam ni lah. Dia akan melalui satu line saja. Dia naik, dia turun. Lepas tu dia naik balik, dia turun. Naik, dia turun. Dalam masa 0.02 saat, berlaku electromagnetic induction itu kan. Tetapi sebenarnya ini adalah ideal case. Apa maksud ideal case? We assume that the core is perfect. Kita assume that the core is perfect. But in real world, the core is not perfect. Itu yang dimaksudkan dengan residual flux. Nanti ada kita, saya akan tunjukkan satu contoh, the phenomenon of the hysteresis ni. Macam mana hysteresis berlaku? Okay, it is easily can be explained by using this figure. Okay, as you can see, ini AC current. AC current, dia sinusoidal waveform like this. Okay, so kita plot sebenarnya ni current versus time lah. minor pen. This is actually current versus time. As the time goes, in one cycle ni sebenarnya dalam tempoh 0.02 second. Kalau kita supply kita punya domestic punya ni lah. Domestic current kan. 240 volt sambung dekat plug tu. Apa yang apa yang kita dapat nampak cycle yang macam tu lah. Itu sebenarnya I got my tablet lost connection. Sekejap eh. I need to okay. Retry. Saya rasa ada isu dengan security ni. Asal ni jadi macam ni eh. Sekejap. I don't know what happened. It says that could not log in to any this without mask. Let's try. And the desk is ready. Remote user has rejected your session. I don't know what happened. Just allow me to fix this in few minutes. Set. Start now. Okay. Okay, it is fixed now. Alright. So, alright. So, let me explain it again. Okay, this is the cycle of AC current. Dia ada positive cycle dan negative cycle. Pada masa current ini bertambah ke peak. Okay. Boleh tengok kat bawah ni. So, flux akan bertambah. Flux akan bertambah ke sini. Okay. Dalam textbook, dia state daripada ni ke A ke B. Ke B kan? Daripada A kat sini. A kat sini. Ke B. Alright. Sini A ke B. Then, bila yang merah ni pula, bila dia turun, daripada peak kepada zero, dia cuba kembali ke zero ni. Dia cuba kembali ke A. Tetapi, disebabkan ada residual flux. Maknanya, tak semua flux tu jadi zero. Tak semua flux tu jadi zero. So, dia akan lalu different path. Different laluan lah. Ke sini. Yang merah ni. Lalu different path. Okay. And then, tengok yang hijau ni. Bila we apply the negative current, maknanya current tu dah negative cycle kan? Negative cycle to peak of the negative cycle. Then, flux ni akan naik secara negatif lah. Okay? Dan sampai ke sini. Begitu juga ni. Kembali ke zero. Then, flux will be return but not using the middle path. Okay? Dia tak melalui laluan yang tengah disebabkan oleh residual flux. Okay. So, it doesn't go through the original path and then it will pass through this and then go back to B. So, dia akan jadi macam ni lah. Macam apa ni? Macam lintah macam tu lah. Pernah tengok lintah tak? Tak pernah. Dia macam ni lah. Suppose kita expect sepatutnya dia kena jadi macam ni lah. Barulah dia ideal kan. Tapi disebabkan hysteresis, dia akan berlaku fenomena like this. This is what we call as hysteresis loop. Okay? Because of the flux history. Bila kita apply current, dia akan ada flux dalam ferromagnetic core itu, tetapi tidak semua flux akan kembali kepada asal. Dan disebabkan residual flux itulah, dia akan tak jadi zero. Dia akan lalu bukan zero lah, non-zero. Okay? Dia macam ni. So, this is the phenomenon what we call as the hysteresis. Okay? This is another explanation about hysteresis in terms of atomic structure. Okay, in terms of atomic structure. Ini gambar raja yang tadi lah.
According this is the explanation. Lehmann, atoms consist of three basic particles, protons,
Dia pun nak cakap juga. Okay, so ini yang tadilah, explanation yang tadilah. Bila you tengok dekat textbook ini, mungkin susah nak imagine kan. Tengok lecture notes lah. Okay. Bila meningkat, meningkat A ke B, then turun. Ada explanation dia kat sini ya. Further explanation is available here. You can read and try to understand it. Then, I'm going to explain about the behavior of ferromagnetic core berkenaan dengan hysteresis tadi in terms of atomic structure. Okay, atomic structure. Let's say this is the... Saya nak rujuk kepada nota saya. That is the normal condition of magnetic domains. Magnetic domains tu apa? Anak panah ni. Ini dipanggil magnetic domains. Vector of the flux. Okay? Okay, vector of the flux. Dalam any material, like for example, if I am holding this, mana? Material lah. Any material. Tak ada material yang... Contoh yang bagus sini. Any material, tak kira lah. Katalah ini besi kan, iron kan. Secara semula jadi, di dalam ni, dia ada, if we zoom in and then we look into in microscopic punya window kan, kita akan nampak sebenarnya dalam ni ada magnetic domains. Ada magnetic domains yang secara... secara naturalnya, dia punya flux punya ataupun domains punya alignment itu dia random. Kenapa random? Dia follow the conservation of energy lah. Okay? Maknanya, besi ni stable lah. Dia bukan unstable material lah yang boleh dijadikan sebagai macam nuclear punya tu kan? Bukan. Dia stable material. That's why kita tengok dia punya magnetic domains ini. Kau berapa dah? Dia punya magnetic domains ini random. Okay? So, pada masa ni dia tak jadi magnet lagi. Sebab kita tak supply any current. Okay? We didn't do any windings to this material and we didn't supply any current. This is the normal condition. Kalau tengok satu-satu anak panah ni, ni ke atas. Kalau titik tu maknanya out of the page. Ke arah saya lah, ke arah saya. Kalau ni anak panah ke bawah. Okay? Ini dia ikut flux punya direction lah. Okay. So, and then what happen is, we apply the external MMF. We apply the external MMF, which is in the situation like this. Situation like this, we apply current so that with that number of turns, number of turn times current is MMF, right? So, we apply external MMF to that particular material, it becomes magnet. So, kita apply MMF, dia akan jadi magnet. Maknanya, bahagian sini, bahagian kanan ni adalah north. Bahagian north pole. Bahagian bawah ni south pole lah. Right? So, it becomes magnet where the arrow or the magnetic domains tu, dia align macam ni. Dia align macam ni. Bila kita supply current. Bila kita supply MMF, apa yang berlaku is like this lah. And then, when MMF is removed, bila kita stop supplying the current, okay? Bila kita stop supplying the current, suppose what we can imagine inside that magnetic domain is, suppose it should go back to this original condition lah. Patutnya kan? Maksudnya, sepatutnya domain-domain ni kembali kepada asal. Tetapi ini tidak berlaku. This is not going to happen because of the residual flux because of the residual flux. Even MMF is removed. For example, if we can have a look at this arrow, yang ni dah kembali kepada asal. Yang ni, yang ni kembali kepada asal juga. Yang ni kembali kepada asal. How about this one? Yang ni dia kekal. Masih lagi macam ni, ke arah kanan. Yang ni ke arah kanan, straight. Sebenarnya yang asal macam ni. Dia tak kembali kepada asal. Dan yang ni pun tak kembali kepada asal. Sepatutnya into the page macam ni kan. Tapi directionnya ke arah kanan juga. Yang ni pun, yang ni kembali kepada asal. Yang ni kembali kepada asal. Yang ni tidak kembali kepada asal. Dia remain unchanged. The direction of the arrow is remain unchanged. The vector of the magnetic domains itu unchanged. It doesn't revert to its original position. Okay? Sama juga macam analogi ataupun saya ceritakan sebelum ni juga. Bila kita buat eksperimen, semasa kita belajar fizik dulu kan, kita ambil paku and then kita lilitkan paku itu dengan copper wire dan kita letakkan bateri. Okay, dan kita supply lah current. Maknanya kita supply MMF to that paku ataupun iron. What happen is, bila kita ambil staples ni, kita keluarkan staples kan. Kita keluarkan staples. So, kita paku tu, kita dekatkan dengan staples tu. Apa yang berlaku, staples tu akan melekat pada paku. And then, kita pun buang bateri tu. And then, kita tengok tak semua staples tu yang lekat tadi tu jatuh. Ataupun ada lagi staples. Maksudnya paku tu masih lagi seolah-olah macam dia tu magnet lagi. Okay? Dia tak jadi besi balik. Dia tak, jadi non-magnet. Dia masih lagi ada sifat-sifat magnet. Disebabkan oleh history flux itu tadi ataupun residual flux. Okay? So, because of that residual flux, when we operate the machine, the electrical machine, okay, we'll need to give more current. Maksudnya?
Here's what I found on the web.
We'll need to supply more current in order to make sure that we can push that. Saya tunjukkan ni. Kita kena supply more current so that we can push this to zero, to the ideal path. Maksudnya itulah extra current ataupun extra energy itulah kita panggil coercive MMF. Coercive MMF is the extra energy applied to make sure that we can operate that machine in the region that is similar to the ideal region lah. Okay. So, maksudnya, itulah loss dalam machine yang associated to the hysteresis loss. Because of the application, more energy is required, which is coercive MMF itu, untuk kita kembalikan operational path itu kepada yang ideal punya. Itulah energy loss dalam bentuk hysteresis yang dimaksudkan di sini. Alright. So, another loss is eddy current loss. Okay, another loss is eddy current loss, which is this slide, right? Start from this slide. So, what is eddy current loss? Okay, eddy current loss ini simple saja. Apabila kita operate machine, contohnya transformer, kita sentuh tempat, satu-satu tempat ada transformer itu, kita rasa dia macam panas. Panas. Kan? Itulah disebabkan oleh loss because of the swell of current ini. Swell of current, which is kita panggil dalam istilah electromagnetism, kita panggil eddy current loss. Eddy current loss. So eddy current loss ini biasanya dia punya path. Dia punya path ini perpendicular to the flux path. Okay. Ini adalah eddy current loss. Apabila kita supply MMF kepada core ini, what happen is Because of the voltage induced inside this core, bila ada potential, akan ada current akan melalui satu path because of the resistance. So, dalam elektrik, dia tak boleh lari dah. Bila ada voltage, ada resistor, akan menyebabkan current. So, inilah current. Current yang dipanggil eddy current loss. Eddy current lah. Okay. So, eddy current tu disebabkan oleh core itu sendiri. Core itu sendiri. That is why in industrial transformer is being produced by lamination lah, lamination of its core. Maksudnya dia tak gunakan satu solid core macam ni. Kalau solid core ni akan menyebabkan more eddy current loss. Okay, the transformer construction normally it will be split into many laminated core yang kecil-kecil, yang sekeping-sekeping macam tu, macam ni, untuk minimiskan eddy current loss. Dan in between this core ni, dia letakkan macam satu penebak lah, satu. Okay, kalau you buka transformer tu, apa yang dalam tu, okay, akan ada macam something like ada lamination lah, ada plastik kan, plastik untuk tidak, supaya current path itu berlaku dalam setiap kepingan itu saja. Okay, swirl of current itu which is only inside the individual laminated coin. Okay, maknanya the current path is now minimized to minimize the loss associated to eddy current loss. So eddy current loss ni dia menyebabkan apa? Dia akan menyebabkan dari segi operating temperature, okay? Kalau loss tu tinggi, maknanya panas sangat benda tu kan? Dia akan menyebabkan lagi banyak loss bila panas. Okay? That's why anda dalam transformer yang besar-besar, power transformer yang deal with 11 kV, 200, more than 200 kilovolt, sebenarnya dia ada macam penyejuk, sistem penyejukan. Sama ada menggunakan minyak. Biasanya menggunakan minyak lah. Okay? Untuk menyejukkan transformer. Alright? So, untuk menyejukkan transformer. So, operating temperature will be affected by the eddy current losses. And also, of course, when eddy current loss occurs in transformer or machines, it will affect the efficiencies lah. Efficiencies. Okay. So, Faraday's law, saya rasa saya akan teruskan dalam kita punya next session, next week on Sunday 3 to 5 kan. So, untuk hari ini, saya akan finish, I will finish up to this slide sajalah. Okay. So, ke nak teruskan yang ni ya? Sampai Faraday's law, Lenz law. Sebab ini dah masuk ke section lain. Nanti teruskan yang ni, dia dah sampai ke ni je. Ke separuh jalan habisnya. Okay. Tutorial. So, untuk sesi yang hari ni, kita habis kat sini. So, any further inquiries or any further inquiries, you can ask me via our WhatsApp group. And also my advice is again and again, always just to push you to do that. Make sure that you follow all of the lectures. Saya akan upload juga recordings untuk hari ini. So make sure that you follow all the lectures after you finish this real-time session kan. Maksudnya lepas ni pun jangan lupa make sure that you follow all of the tutorials, discussion that I have upload here. And I think I didn't miss any tutorials. All of them has been uploaded, start from tutorial 1.1 up to tutorial 1.10. Ada sampai 1.10. Semua sekali tutorial untuk 1.11 pun ada. Sekali ya. Yeah. Untuk chapter 1 there are a lot of tutorials so that you have to follow. Okay. Chapter 1 banyak sangat tutorial. Then when it comes to quiz question, of course I will ask about things that we have gone through in this lecture and also in the tutorial lah. Alright. Okay, so right. So I will stop right now. Stop recording dah.